Adalimumab, or Humira, is one of the most common biologic medications that we use for patients suffering from inflammatory arthritis, like rheumatoid arthritis, psoriatic arthritis, or ankylosing spondylitis. I consider that education is key in understanding the benefits, but also the risk of using this medication. That is why, before I start my patients on this medication, I will discuss in detail the risk and the benefits of the therapy. In this video, I will answer the most common questions related to Humira therapy. What is adalimumab or Humira? What is the effect of Humira in arthritis patients? Is Humira a pill or an injectable medication? What tests are needed before you start therapy? Can Humira be combined with other medications such as biologics? And what are the most common side effects of this medication? Can Humira increase the risk of infections, and how common are severe infections? How can you prevent certain infections? Can Humira increase the risk of cancer? And is Humira safe for patients with heart failure? What vaccines are recommended before you start therapy? And the last, is Humira safe for pregnancy?
RheumatologistOnCall.com.
Hi, I'm Dr. Diana Garnita, the founder of Rheumatologist on Call. Thank you for watching my YouTube channel, where I talk about autoimmune diseases, but also lifestyle changes to help you thrive with arthritis. So don't forget to subscribe and share the channel with people that are suffering. Let's begin. What is adalimumab or Humira? It is a medication from the TNF-alpha inhibitors class. It is prescribed to patients with moderate to severe cases of rheumatoid arthritis. Humira is a recombinant monoclonal antibody. What it does, it's going to bind to tumor necrosis factor alpha, which is a well-known molecule that will cause inflammation into your body. This is a very powerful medication that we use for patients that actually failed other therapies, like disease-modifying drugs or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medications. What is the effect of Humira in arthritis patients? Patients with inflammatory arthritis, like rheumatoid arthritis or psoriatic arthritis, they have high levels of inflammation. Inflammation may be present systemically, which will affect multiple organs, but it can be present just in your joints. The treatment with adalimumab works to reduce the signs and symptoms, and it will inhibit the progression of your joint damage, and it will improve your physical function. Humira will interfere with the TNF-alpha molecules that are found in high levels in your fluid in the joints, and that's how it's going to be helpful for you. Is Humira a pill or an injectable medication? Humira or adalimumab, it's a medication that you can give to yourself usually every other week. It can come in a pen or in a syringe form, and it may be given in the thigh or the abdomen area. It is recommended that you rotate the site of injection every time when you have to give yourself the injection. You should leave it at the room temperature for about 15 to 30 minutes before you use it, but do not remove the cap or cover during this time. And you do not use it if the solution is discolored, and you are not going to give yourself the injection in an area of a skin that is bruised, scarred, or has any changes. What tests are needed before starting therapy? Before starting therapy with adalimumab or Humira, it is important to be screened for latent tuberculosis, for hepatitis B and C. You will also need other tests like a CBC, a complete metabolic panel, and HIV screening in those patients that are high risk. Laboratory tests are also needed during the therapy with Humira. And for that, I will recommend you to discuss with your physician about how frequent you need laboratory monitoring. Can Humira be combined with other medications, such as biologics? Humira is safe to be combined with other disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs, for example, methotrexate, leflunomide, sulfasalazine, or hydroxychloroquine. However, it is not recommended to be associated with other TNF-alpha inhibitors or other biologics due to an increased risk for infections. What are the most common side effects of adalimumab? Now, I will tell you about the most common side effects reported by patients on adalimumab. Skin rash, a positive NA titer, infections like upper respiratory infections such as sinusitis, injection site reactions or hypersensitivity reaction, nervous system symptoms such as headaches and back pain, cardiovascular complications such as acute myocardial infarction, cardiac arrhythmia, chest pain, and palpitations, sometimes more rarely gastrointestinal issues such as abdominal pain, and at times hair loss or alopecia. Can Humira increase the risk of infections? And how common are the severe infections? Humira puts patients at an increased risk of developing infections, especially if it's used in combination with other drugs that will lower your immune system, for example, methotrexate or corticosteroids. The risk for a serious infection is about 4 to 5%. Infections include active tuberculosis or reactivation of a latent tuberculosis, but also fungal infections or other bacterial or viral infections, such as herpes zoster or hepatitis B. Now, if you get an infection, you should stop the medication and call your physician immediately. How can you decrease the risk of developing certain infections? I always recommend getting up to date with all immunizations. For example, flu vaccine, pneumonia vaccine, COVID-19 vaccine, and herpes zoster vaccine. And that I will recommend to all my patients prior to starting therapy, unless they have a contraindication. However, I recommend against getting live vaccines during the therapy with Humira. Can Humira increase the risk of cancer? Lymphoma and other malignancies are rare, but they have been reported in patients taking TNF-alpha inhibitors. For example, lymphoma and non-melanoma skin cancers were reported. However, the risk of getting a malignancy on this medication is still under debate. But you should check with your doctor if you have any weight loss, any chills, night sweats, any symptoms like lymph nodes, and you should also have a skin exam done every year. Is Humira safe for patients with heart failure? Patients on TNF-alpha inhibitors rarely develop new onset or worsening of the heart failure. But if you suffer from a cardiac disease, you should disclose that to your physician that will order a full cardiac evaluation prior for you to start this therapy. Is Humira safe for pregnancy? The risk of using Humira during pregnancy is considered moderate to low. No risk or adverse maternal or fetal effects were observed following adalimumab exposure during pregnancy. If you remain pregnant on this medication, it is important for you to contact your physician. It is also considered to be safe to continue therapy until 32 weeks of pregnancy. All TNF-alpha blockers were also considered safe during breastfeeding. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you've learned something new and valuable about treating inflammatory arthritis. If you are interested in learning more, if you like the educational content of my videos, or if you know someone that is suffering from an autoimmune disease, make sure to like, share, and subscribe to my channel so you will be notified every time when I'm posting a new video.
RheumatologistOnCall.com.
Have a great day, and I will see you soon.